Hello children, in this video we are going to learn the characteristics of living beings. Children, you already know that plants and animals are living beings. There are certain characteristics to decide them as living beings. Now let us learn the characteristics of living beings one by one briefly. Living beings are made up of cells. You must have observed how a house is being constructed. When several things such as bricks, cement, water, steel are arranged in an order, a house gets ready. Similarly, the body of living beings is made up of cells. Observe these pictures. They are of plant and animal cells. You will learn more about cells in higher classes. Living beings respire. There are special organs to respire in animals. The lungs are the most important organs that help human beings in respiration. Animals such as earthworms breathe through their skin. Fish use gills for breathing. And plants respire through stomata. Living beings eat food. Living beings do many works daily. To do these works, living beings need energy. They get this energy through food. Plants prepare their own food. I have already explained the process of photosynthesis. I hope you remember that. Living beings grow. These pictures show the growth of that particular organism. In every picture, there is an increase in height and size. This is called as growth. Living beings move. Movement is a living characteristic, especially of animals. Animals move from one place to another. They have special organs for this. Plants do not have organs for movement as in animals. As soil holds the root of plants, they cannot move from one place to another. Still, we can observe some movements in plants. See the picture, roots growing towards water in the soil, sunflower plant turning towards the sun. Living beings excrete. Animals throw out unwanted things of the body in the form of carbon dioxide, sweat, feces and urine. They have special organs for this purpose. Plants release excess water to the atmosphere through leaves. As a result, plants do not dry up. Dry leaf, stem, rotting parts, all these separate from the plants. Living beings reproduce. Observe the organisms and their young ones in the picture. The process of an organism giving birth to young ones which resemble it is called reproduction. Some animals carry out reproduction by laying eggs and some others by directly giving birth to young ones. Plants reproduce through seeds and stems. Living beings respond to stimulus. When you touch a hot vessel, you feel pain, isn't it? Some insects bite us when we touch them. Have you observed folding of leaves in touch-me-not plant when you touch it? All these are the responses given by organisms to the surrounding stimulus. Usually they respond to touch, heat, cold, sound, and smell. Living beings have lifespan. Organisms take birth, become adults, reproduce, become old, and die at last. The period between life and death of an organism is called lifespan. The average lifespan of some animals are given in this picture. Please observe. Based on the lifespan, plants are classified into annuals, biennials, and perennials. Understand it through this picture. Annuals, plants which bear flower, produce fruits and die in a year or a season. Example, jowar, wheat, paddy, pumpkin, vegetables, cotton. Biennials, plants which live up to 2 years or 2 seasons produce flower, fruit and seeds and die. Example, carrot, ginger, cabbage, sugarcane, beetroot. Perennials, plants which live for many years and keep producing flower, fruit and seeds. Example, mango, lemon, coconut, neem, jackfruit, arecanut. Children, the living world around us is a wonder. Knowing about the plants and animals, we should protect them. Then only the existing environment we see now will be available to the future generations. Remember always that if we protect nature, it will protect us. Children, hope you understood the characteristics of living beings. In the next video, we will learn a new concept. Take care. Thank you.